Hello friends, welcome. Welcome to your YouTube channel, Praj Academy. Let me say a few words about Praj Academy. The sole purpose of Praj Academy is to let the people create second source of income, grow their wealth consistently, and be financially free through trading and investing in the stock market. We believe that each and every person is talented enough to learn and be a financial wizard if his potential is worked out with, or rather if his potential is unlocked by providing quality training. We live to fulfill your dream of being wealthy and financially free, and our dream of creating 1 million millionaires during our lifetime. Yeah. So the first step to learn technical analysis is to know and master the indicators and oscillators. Right? These are the tools which are used in technical analysis. The first and the foremost important tool or indicator is called moving average. Let's go to the technical chart where you can see the candlesticks, and moving average is a most common but most important indicator used in technical analysis. So what does moving average do? The moving average smoothens out the price action by filtering the noise from random short-term price fluctuation. As you know, the price keeps on going up and down, and over a period of time, that fluctuation is filtered out by moving average. Moving average is a trend following indicator. It lets you know how the trend is showing up. This indicator is a lagging indicator. Reason being very simple, it follows the prices of past periods. It could be 5 days, it could be 10 days average of the price. There could be two kind of moving averages: simple moving average, which is also known as SMA, or exponential moving average. Now, in a simple moving average, what you do, let's say for an example, if you want to have 5 days simple moving average, so 5 days closing prices divided by 5 would be your 5 days moving average. So how you can calculate your simple moving average is, let's say day one moving average on, let's say on Nifty future, you say it was 12,000. Let's say it was 12,000 and next was 12,100. Next price was 12,060. Next closing price was 12,000, let's say 45, yeah. And the fifth one is 12,200. So if you sum them up, and divide them by 5, you have gotten the 5 day moving average, right? This is how the 5 day moving average will come. Now you can say if you divide it by, you will get a 12,200. So that is the moving average of 5 days. Now next day, what we do? Let's say the next day moving average was, we'll drop the first moving average. We'll take up 12,000. So let's say that was our moving average on day one, right? This was our moving average on day one. We'll calculate it this way. Now let's say on moving average on day two. How do we calculate that? Let's say now we'll be dropping the first day moving average here, first day average, and we'll be taking as 12,000. Let's say 12,100 plus 12,200 plus 12,300 plus 12,400. Now let us say the latest moving average was 12,500. If you multiply this by 5, you will get a new moving average, and that will be 12,300. Make sense? Now how you can draw this is in the form of line. Your first point will be coming at 12,200, next point will be coming at 12,300 with a 1 day time frame, right? Of course, you don't need to calculate it when you are trading. You see, it will simply be provided to you, when you select this indicator on your chart, right? I'm sure now you have understood this. All right, so that's how your moving average is coming. So the most common application of moving average is to identify the trend. The trend can be identified in various time frames. You can say a short term or very short term. The first trend could be very short term. That can be identified by 5 or 13 days moving average. You can also have short term, right? So short term can be identified by 10, 15, 20 or 25 days moving average. And you can have a medium term trend that could be identified by 50 and 100 days moving average. Then there could be a long term trend that could be identified by 100 and 200 days moving averages, right? So this is how you would identify the various kind of trends. My friends, you would be seeing it whenever you are seeing somebody's technical analysis, including my own technical analysis, which I put on Facebook or on Twitter. So you would see I'm talking about short-term trend is bullish or bearish, right? So how do we calculate? How do we say that? That's based upon these number of days moving averages, right? One more application of the moving averages is to determine the support and resistance levels, right? So if you are looking at us at a moving average, so what do? We first apply one moving average, right? It's easy to, let's say I'm working on a platform where I can simply say add a moving average here, right? So we'll go to the average and we'll say take exponential moving average, and we'll say take 5 days moving average, right? We can give it a color of your choice. Let's say we'll pick up blue and red, and we will say to plot it, right? So this is a 5 days moving average now, right? So you can see on a very, very short term when the trend is bullish or bearish, right? When the price is above the moving average, we say the price is bullish. And when it is below the moving average, we say it's a bearish trend, right? Since it is a it's a lagging indicator. You would see it will not immediately identify when the trend has been changed, but it will identify after a few candlesticks, right? So that was now. As I said, we will be looking at a very short-term moving, a very short-term trend by looking at two moving averages. Let's draw another moving average, right? So we will say average. We'll pick up the average, and this time we will say draw 13 days moving average, right? And this time we'll pick another color so that we can distinguish clearly. And we'll draw it here, right? I'm sure you can identify these two colors separately. And what you can observe here is in a short term price at this point of time went above these both moving averages. So it was a bullish trend. It continued a bullish trend, right? The price remained above both the moving averages. And at this point of time, the price came below the moving averages, right? So it became bearish. But just few days later, again, the price went above both the moving averages and it has become bullish. And at present, the price is bullish. So that's one application. So in a very short term, we can say the price is, the trend is bullish. Now let us say we want to see it in a, So in a very short term, the price is bullish. Now let's look at the short term, right? So short term, we look at 15 days moving average, or rather we can look at 20 days moving average. So we'll modify that. Let me take 25 days moving average, right? Let me take out this moving average along with the chart. Now let's say in a short term, the price has become bullish from all over here on 11th October, and the price has been bullish, except during this period, the price became bearish. So on this date, on 9th October, you see, 9th December, the price became bearish. It went below both the moving averages on 10th December as well as on 11th December. But on 12th December, the price went above short-term moving averages and it remained bullish since then, right? So that's how you look at the short-term moving average. Now let's look at the medium-term moving average. We look at, let's say 50 days. And we look at 100 days moving average. Looking at these two moving averages, we can say in the medium term how market has been performing. Give me a minute. So let's look at this chart. For quite some time, I think from February 2009, the market has been bullish, and somewhere here the price came for a short while, the price came below moving average on a medium term. It became bearish, but it was only for a few days, and again the price came below it on July 19th. It became bearish. It remained bearish until this large candle came. I'm sure many of you would remember this is called Nirmala candle, right? our finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman made certain statement that day, and the market zoomed up. It was about the corporate tax reduction from 30% to 20%, 25%, right? So the corporate tax reduction was a very good news for the market, and that's where the price jump came in. So price became bullish, and for a few days it came again below the moving averages. That's medium term moving average, right? And then again it went up, and right now on a medium term the price is bullish, the market is bullish, right? Let's look at the long term. Now long term we look at 150 to 200 days moving average. Again, we superimpose both of them. Now look at the price except. Now again, let's go for some time back. If you look at from this time around, January 17, the price has been bullish. In the month of February, in the month of March, for a few days, the price came below these moving averages. It was bearish only for a few days. Then it went up. And again, in October, month of October on 18th, it became bearish. For a few months, it remained bearish. It tried to go up. The market was in a sideways that time. It was going up and down from these moving averages. And from, let's say, 1st March 19, itself on a long-term market became bullish, right? And it continued. Again, it became bearish. Again, it became bullish here, right? So that's how you look at the various kind of trends, right? On a short-term, very short-term, short-term, medium-term, and long-term. Now, one more application. The third application. No, the second application of moving averages is to determine the support and resistance levels. Support and resistance levels are very important levels, friends. You would see when the price is above these moving averages, whenever it falls, these moving averages provide it a support. For an example, at this place, the price went up and the price came down. At this level, 11,146, in the month of May, 150 days moving average provided it the support. Then the price went up from here and the price again came down. And this day, 19 July, the same 150 days moving average provided the support. And the support could not sustain for more than a day, and next day the support was broken. But next day, 200 days moving average provided the support. Next to next day, again 200 days moving average kept on providing the support. After 2 days, that moving average was broken and the price was below, the market became bearish. And I was saying earlier, the same moving average, once the price is below the moving average, provides resistance. Now what happened? After that, once, twice, thrice, fourth time, right? The market tried to go up, but this 200 days moving average did not allow it to go up. So it was a very strong resistance there, and the market further fell down, right? It came down. To break this resistance level of 200 and 150 days, the market had to have a very large bullish candlestick, a very, very large volume of buying that day happened on 20th September, right? And the market became further bullish. And when market tried to go down, it provided again the support here and the resistance here. And you can see on this day, 150 days
was a resistance, while as 200 days is a was a support. On this day, 200 days as well as 150 days were support, and the market continues to be in uptrend from that time onwards, right? So these were the support and resistance level application on moving averages, right? Now, third application of moving averages is to find out what is the strength of this trend. It may be bearish trend, it may be bullish trend, or it may be downtrend, or it may be uptrend, depending upon where the price is existing below the moving averages or above the moving averages, right? So how do we look at strength of the trend when two moving averages, observe the chart, my friends, when two moving averages are parting away from each other, we say the trend is becoming stronger. If you see, the distance was very less between two moving averages, it kept on increasing, and accordingly the price was going up and up far away from these moving averages. That means during this period, when these two moving averages of different time frames were diverging, that time the trend was strong, and the trend was broken here, and the price came up again. And you would see at this point of time, the distance in comparison with previous time, the distance was reduced, and these two moving averages started coming closer to each other, right? And here the price has gone in the bearish trend. Now you see, further after some time, these two moving averages came very close to each other. That means the trend during this period here was weaker. Whenever there is a sideways trend, these moving averages will come very close to each other. Now we are looking at a daily chart, and we can refer to, let's say, if we see on the smaller time frames, we will be using, let's say, 20 and 25 days moving average, right? And let's say pick up 25 days here. It may give you a better understanding of it. Yeah. Now you can see, when the market became sideways, these two moving averages came very, very close to each other. And again, when the market became bullish, they started going far off. When the market was reversing, these two moving averages came close to each other, right? That's how the moving averages provide you directions, the strength of trend, right? Now the fourth application of moving averages is finding out the trend reversal. So how do we find trend reversal? As we said, when two moving averages are parting from each other, they are at more distance away from each other, the trend is stronger. Contrast to that, when these two moving averages try to come closer to each other, we say now the trend has become weaker. Whenever these two moving averages cross each other and the smaller moving average is below large moving average, we say the trend has reversed from bullish, now it has turned to be bearish. whenever the smaller moving average is above the bigger moving average and the price is above both, we say it is a bullish trend, right? Now look at this chart. At this point of time, the smaller moving average, let's say the bigger moving average, we make thicker, right? So that you can distinguish it very quickly. Yeah. So now, at this point of time, the smaller moving average is above the larger moving average and the price is above it. So trend became bullish here. And over a period of time, they came closer to each other. At this point, the market was sideways. It became further weaker and there is a crossover here at this point of time. And in that crossover, you would see the larger moving average now has gone upside and the smaller average has come downside and the price has also gone below both the moving average. This is where we say the crossover has happened, crossover of two moving averages has happened and the price has gone below it. Now the market has become bearish. So this is the sign of trend reversal. Now, although the trend reversal has happened much earlier here, but the moving averages are lagging indicator because you are calculating the moving average price based upon the previous 10, 15, 20, whatever period you have picked up, that number of days moving averages. Hence, there is a lag and that is also reflecting in you identifying the trend reversal little later. All right. Now the reversal trend continues and you would see the two moving averages are going far off from each other and the downtrend is becoming stronger. And at this point of time, they came very close to each other. The downtrend became weaker. And at this point of time, they crossed over. It became bullish trend again. So trend reversal can also be found out with the help of moving averages, right? All right. The fifth application of moving averages is in creating other indicators. You might have heard of indicators like MACD, that is moving average convergence divergence indicator. So that indicator also is created out of different kind of moving averages, right? So we'll be creating another video for that. Due to the shortage of time, we cannot have everything in one video. And there is one very popular indicator called Bollinger Band, right? So that Bollinger Band is also created from moving averages. So these are the two indicators we will be taking up in separate video. For right now, these were the applications of moving averages. Now, can we deploy moving averages for taking trading decisions, for taking short or long? Yes, we can. There are various trading strategies which are created based upon moving averages, and that we will cover in any of next videos. If you want to know about more technical indicators or you have any questions about how to do technical analysis, you can put into your comment box, right? And please don't forget to like and subscribe our YouTube channel. This YouTube channel has been created to enhance your learning and knowledge. We are committed. You get a world-class knowledge free of cost at your doorstep through our YouTube videos. Thank you for watching. We appreciate and we wish you good luck. We wish you best of trading and investing experience. May God bless you. May God make you wealthy and financially free. Thank you.